Hi there, and welcome to this video. In this video, let's see how you can set up OpenLightspeed WordPress on Volta. So the Volta OpenLightspeed WordPress template can be found here. If you come under Marketplace, you click on OpenLightspeed WordPress. That's going to show you the WordPress template with OpenLightspeed. And all the other components can be found here. You can see what it comes with: WordPress, OpenLightspeed, MariaDB, PHP, Satbot for SSL, PHP MyAdmin, Memcached, and Redis. So you can use whichever one you prefer. First of all, we're going to deploy it, and then we're going to log into our server. And once you log in, it's going to automatically start the setup process. So something else you're going to need is you're going to need a domain. So buy the domain, or if you already have one, connect the domain to Cloudflare. You can buy your domain wherever you prefer and connect it to Cloudflare. So I'll use this. Once you connect your domain to Cloudflare, come down here under DNS. And this is where we're going to add our records so that it points to our server on Volta. We'll get here once we have an IP. We'll start doing that once we get an IP. So let's come back to Volta, and we're going to deploy that OpenLightspeed WordPress template. So if you already have an account, log into your Volta account. If you're new to Volta, you can get $300 of free credits. I will add the link in the description for you. If I come here under products, it's going to show me that I don't have any instances yet. I'm going to deploy one. You can click on deploy right there. Any button with deploy, you can always click on it, and it will lead you to deploying your server. So I'm just going to click there on deploy. I'm just going to click here on deploy. Just click on any deploy button. It will bring you to deploying a server or deploying other items. But the one we need is deploying a server. I'm going to use the shared CPU. And I'm going to stick with Chicago as my data center. So always pick the location that is closest to your visitors. If your target audience for your website is in Germany, then choose a location in Germany. If it's in the UK, choose a location in the UK. Wherever your audience is, that's where you select your data center. In this case, I'm going to choose Chicago as my example for this demonstration. The type of server, high frequency, I'll go with high frequency. High frequency, I don't think they have AMD. Yeah, so I'll go with high performance, and I will stick with AMD. And I want two virtual CPUs and 4GB of RAM, and that will be $24 a month. Now, this server is enough to power over 500K of monthly visitors. And you can always upgrade. In case you see the CPU or the RAM is being overutilized, then you can always upgrade to the next server, and that is possible in your Volta account. So $24 a month. And if you come down here, you're going to see it's 28. That's because automatic backups have been turned on. Is go to the next step. I'll just click there on configure. Click on marketplace. And you're going to select OpenLightspeed WordPress. The next thing is the server settings. So if you do have an SSH key added to your Volta, and I do have a video showing you how to do that, you can select your SSH key, and that's what you're going to use to log into your server. But in this case, I just want to use a password, so I'm going to skip that. I'm not going to select anything there. And this means that Volta is going to generate a password for me. Startup script, I will pass that as well. And then for the server host name and label, and I want to call it, let me just call it wp-hosting-tips.uk. For the server label, you can call it whatever you prefer, but I'll just leave it to be similar to the host name. And then additional features, automatic backups. This is what's adding the $4 on top of your 24. So I can't stress this enough. Automatic backups are important. Make sure you leave them checked. One day your server might get compromised, and the only thing that's going to save you is your backup. So make sure you have automatic backups enabled. And then public IP, of course, I want a public IP. I also want an IPv6 IP. then DDoS protection is $10 a month. So if that's something you need, you can select it. All these others, I'll just leave them as they are, but I can create a limited user. So the limited user is going to give me a sudo user that I can use instead of using the root user. So that's pretty much it for my server. So I'm going to click there on deploy. All right. So there you can see our server is being deployed. The IP is ready. So I'll just click on it. First thing, let me set up DNS for this server. So I'll copy the first IP, which is IPv4, and then I'll go back to Cloudflare and I will create an A record. So A record, and I will use at, and then I will add the IP. And I don't know the implication of enabling this at this point, especially for setting up SSL. So I'm going to disable proxying for now, and then I'll save. I just don't want it to affect SSL being issued. And then I can also add the IPv6 address, which is usually added with a code A record. So I'm just going to add a record. I will select the code A record. This one as well will go to at, which signifies the domain name. And then I'm going to paste in the IP. And this one as well, for now, I'm going to unproxy it and then save. And the last one that I want to add, the bare minimum last one that I want to add, is a CNAME record for www. So I'm going to add record, and I'm going to add a CNAME record, and this one is going to be for www, and then the target I'm just going to use at. This one as well I will unproxy. I'm going to proxy them once my SSL has been issued. So I'm going to save. So DNS has been set up. Let's go back to Volta. And right now, if I was to access that IP, it's going to tell me that the server is ready, but I just need to set up WordPress. And the way to do that is to log in via SSH. So if you're on Windows, don't worry, you can do everything I'm doing by simply using Git Bash. So go to your search engine and search for Git. And then for Windows, download, install it, or you can use the portable version. At the end of the day, you just need to use Git Bash. Open Git Bash and follow along step by step. So if you're on a Mac or Linux, just use your terminal. I'm going to use my terminal and copy the IP. Let's log into our server. So SSH, the user is Linux user, at the IP, Control Shift V to paste, and Shift Insert to paste on Git Bash. Accept by typing yes. I'll get the password from here. Copy the password, Control Shift V, enter. There are certain things that are here that you can keep in mind. So you can do sudo cat db password, and this is going to show you the MySQL root password. You can get the web admin password. This is a web admin for Lightspeed by doing sudo cat that. So you can copy this and save it somewhere. This is a sample for me, so I'm not going to save them anywhere. We need to enter a domain. So copy, paste in your domain, and then enter. Type Y to accept. So the domain has been added to the listener. Do you wish to issue a Let's Encrypt certificate for this domain? Yes. Type Y, enter. Please enter your email. You can use your email there. Enter. Verify the email. Yes. Enter. Successfully received a certificate, and your certificate has been stored in this location. Alright, so this means that our HTTPS is now ready. The next step, do you wish to force HTTPS rewrite? Definitely. So I'm going to type yes and then enter. Do you wish to update the system now? This will update the web server as well. So in this case, I can just press enter and it's going to update the system. While that is happening, let's just confirm that on the front end, everything is working. So paste and go. There you go. Now you'll need to install WordPress. You can see your SSL has been issued and the connection is secure. So I'm just going to continue. Error establishing a database connection. This is probably due to the update. So let me wait for the update to complete. Just wait for the update to complete. And then I'm going to try again. All right. So the update is complete and you can try. You can check if there are any more updates. Again, update. Sudo shift dash dash. 13 packages can be upgraded. Let's see. Let's upgrade. Upgrade. Yes. The updates are complete. Let's come back and try the installation one more time. So I'm going to click there on continue. And this time round, you can see it works after the update is completed. So I'm just going to use this as a sample username. Use me today. And the password, I will leave it at that. And then your email, you can use that. You can use your email there. And then if you're building a new website, there's no point of getting it indexed. So I'm going to click there to discourage search engines from indexing the site. And just with that, I'm going to install WordPress. And that took less than a sec. That took less than 30 seconds. You can log into your dashboard. Login. Use me today. Login. And there you go. Your WordPress is now installed. I can see there's an update. Let's check if the update is going to work successfully. Update the plugin. Let's just test if we can install new plugin. So let's go and add a plugin. And this is important because it helps you to know that there are no file permission issues that you need to fix. That's why it's important for me to test this just to make sure that everything will work well for you. So I can install Jetpack just as a sample. Activate. All right. That means that everything is working well, so we don't need to do anything. So I'm just going to click back, come back to the dashboard. So there you go. Your WordPress is installed. SSL is working. Let's also look at the firewall. Sudo ufw status. So this is your firewall on Linux. This is the default on Ubuntu. All right, there you go. Sudo htop. You can see your CPU usage. You can see your CPU usage and your memory usage. Control C. That's pretty much it for that. So that's pretty much it. So if you need help setting up WordPress on a dedicated server or even on VPS, feel free to contact bizanosa.com. Just go to bizanosa.com on the contact page, on the pricing page, all the information you need is there. If you're new to Valtra, take advantage of the $300 free credit in the description below. See you next time.